All right, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to another video on the channel. So today we are doing another review, and that review, as you can tell by the title, is of the new iPhone. This is actually the iPhone 12 Pro Max. I'm honestly super excited to do a review on this iPhone just because I love the way it looks. They really brought back like the iPhone 5 and the iPhone 4, I believe, the look of it, where it's more boxy instead of round, and it doesn't have glass like the iPhone XS Max that I previously had. I didn't want to get the 11 just because it looked the exact same as the XS Max. I don't want to keep you guys too long. We'll hop right into it. And if you guys enjoy any part of the video, let me know by dropping a like on it. And don't forget to subscribe with your notifications turned on so you never miss when I upload a new video, including everything from gaming and tech reviews and all that type of stuff. So without further ado, let's hop right into it.
What a wonderful world.
All right, you guys, let's hop into it. So this is the box that it comes in. It's really nice. Very nice and simple. I remember the old iPhones, they used to come in a thicker box, and I actually like this minimalist style. It's very thin. So as soon as we open it, first things first, you get your phone. And I don't know why exactly there's a tab here. I mean, normally people would just go like that, but I guess it's to just lift it. So this is the phone. Tells you exactly what buttons are which, but I'm pretty sure people can guess what is which. Lets you know the charging is down below. Here, let's get into the rest of the box first. So it does come with a charging cable. I would have hoped so. And they have actually changed the way this connects. So normally it would be a USB and then you'd have the box for it. But now it's the USB-C, I believe. And what else it comes with? The SIM card tool, where you're able to take out your SIM card. And a cool thing I've learned about this new iPhone is that you can actually have two SIM cards, one for business and one for personal. So I feel like a lot of businesses are going to be switching over. And of course you have the sticker that always comes with it. Let's see, what else is in the box? Nothing? I'm surprised they don't give a box to charge anymore, but it's fine. I can still use my old, I don't actually have a box that supports this. I'm just gonna have to use my old charger, but it should be fine. All right, let's hop onto the phone. Let's try peel this off. Very nice and slick. Is it charged? And it is charged, very nice. I love the slick design to it. It reminds me of the old iPhone 5, which is more squared and has more sharp edges. And I love it that it's metal instead of the like the iPhone XS and X's and all that kind of stuff, because it was glass the back. And my phone actually cracked the back, and I'm kind of over it, especially when your hands get either dirty or oily. Your phone actually slips around in your hand, so I'm happy that they changed it back to metal. Hello. All right, let's get some of this started. I want to actually try like the camera, see how it is, because it's supposed to be amazing. I have very high expectations for this phone. And I actually did get the 512 GB just because I use a lot of storage, photos, files for my YouTube channel. I like to bring things from my computer over to my phone and look at it that way, because a lot of people are on mobile now. Not everybody's on desktop. So it's nice to look at things from the mobile perspective just to see if photos are clear, if videos look nice, the audio sounds good. We'll be testing everything. Let me quickly just get my face set up. And another thing I also want to check out is like the new widgets and stuff like that. We should almost be done with the setup. Setup wallet later. We don't need extra space. Screen time, sure, why not? It's always nice to look at that kind of stuff. Don't share, not really into that. See without true tone display. We'll leave it on. It looks nice. Set a lighter dark appearance. See how iOS depending. I always like the darker. Especially it looks nice with my dark phone. We're going to be going with standard. And there we go. Welcome to iPhone. This is the exact same wallpaper that I have for my current iPhone. It's funny because this literally looks just like my phone. I basically can't even tell the difference. Edit home screens. Okay, we know how to do that. I guess there's not much in there. Let's try check out the camera. New quick take video. Tap and hold to shutter to record a quick video. Drag the shutter to the left for burst. Cool. So hold for record. Cool. Oh, and I took the video. And to the left to shutter, right? That's pretty cool. Hold to record. And then it automatically stops, which is really nice. Wow, that's kind of a freaky wide angle, wide zoom. I will also be putting a few images that I will be taking with the wide, the one time zoom, and the 2.5 zoom. They made the customization with so many options, it's kind of crazy. Down to exposure before you even take the picture, not in post edit. Depending on what type of setting you're in. Wow, my phone is getting really hot. I don't know if that's supposed to happen. Weird. I want to try and watch a video. Let's see. YouTube. We'll download YouTube really quick and I want to actually try test out a video. Can I not search the App Store? Do I even have an App Store? That makes no sense. Safari cannot open the page because the address is invalid. Do I not have an App Store? Maybe there's a software update? Alright, I'll be back as soon as this update downloads and installs. Just to see if the App Store downloads by itself. Alright you guys, so we are back and it's updated. Fully, completely download, installed, and everything. And I still do not have an App Store. So I'm really not too sure what to do. I might just have to fully restart. Like, factory reset my iPhone. I don't know what went on with it, why this is happening, but I guess we'll see. Because if you look, I'm actually clicking on search App Store and nothing happens. And say I wanted to go to YouTube. Normally you'd press view and it would take you to the App Store, right? So I would click view. Takes me to the iTunes Store and it takes me here. So up in this top corner, I can click store. But then it brings me to Safari and says Safari cannot open the page because the address is invalid. So it won't even take me to the App Store, which is quite crazy because I can't download any apps right now. So this sucks. I will try to figure this out. So I'll try to figure this out on my own in a bit. And I will be doing a future review just on how things are going with the iPhone, how I'm enjoying it, if I dislike it, what I dislike about it. So I hope to see you guys there. But other than that, I'll see you back on my computer. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I did find a fix for the App Store problem. I basically just had to factory reset my entire phone again, just start from scratch. And good thing I didn't do too much customization because that would have been a drag. So everything's fine now. I'm really enjoying the phone. It feels nice. Watching videos on it is super clean. I can't wait to fast forward about 6 months to make another video to tell you guys how my experience is going. But with all that aside, I'll leave it at that. I hope you guys take care of yourself and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.